you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up.
It's not so long ago that the shout hit the nation. Your favorite radio, and the party's jumping, yeah, and the vibe feels so strong. Throw your hands in the air, lift your head up high. You know you've got to sing along. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. It's not so long ago that the sound hit the nation. Every Saturday night on your favorite radio, and the party's jumping, yeah, and the vibe feels so strong. Throw your hands in the air, lift your head up high. You know you've got to sing along. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. You've got to feel it. What's the name of the jam?
Say I can feel it.
You know you can.
I've got my groove on, and I'm ready to go. Check out my ride, girl, but don't touch my radio. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up. Don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up.
And make me feel good. Make me feel good. Feel so good.
Yo. Hey. Only Borpa. Only Borpa.
Thank you.
Borpa. God, I wish I was Borpa. Why not? Literally, why the F not, bruh?
It's still Dre Day, AK. Though I've grown a lot, can't keep it home a lot.
What'd you guys do today, boy? You got the Rona? Rip.
Dr. Dre is the name. I'm ahead of my gang. Still puffing my leaf. Still with the beats. Still not loving police. Still rock my khakis with a cuff and a crease. Still got love for the...
You moved pallets of soda around for small amounts of money.
Since I left, ain't too much change. Still, I'm representing for the gangsters all across the world.
Sadga.
Hitting them corners in them lolos, girl. Still, taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the DRE. I'm representing for the gangsters all across the world.
Deciding if you want to keep raiding WoW. Is there even new stuff to do in WoW?
Since the last time you heard from me, I lost some friends. Well, hell, me and Snoop, we dipping again. Kept my ear to the streets, signed Eminem. He's triple platinum, doing 50 a week. Still, I stay close to the heat. And even when I was close to defeat, I rose to my feet. My life's like a soundtrack, I wrote to the beat. Street rap like Cali weed, I smoke till I'm asleep. Wake up in the AM, compose a beat. I bring the fire till you're soaking in your seat. It's not a fluke, it's been tried, I'm the truth. Since turn out the lights from
yeah,
the world-class race.
You shitted.
I'm still at it, after mathematics. In the home of drive-bys and agmatics. Swap meets, sticky green.
Deleted slash spit. Cowards! Cowards!
Taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the D.R.E. I'm representing for the gangsters all across the world. Still hitting them corners in the lolos, girl. Still taking my time to perfect the beat.
You had a bad day today? I'm sorry, man.
It's the D.R.E. It ain't nothing but mohawk. Another classic CD for y'all to vibe with. Whether you're cooling on the corner with your fly. Lay back in the shack. Play this track. I'm representing for the gangsters all across the world. I'll break your neck. Put your face in your lap. Try to be the king, but the ace is back. So you wait up on things. Dr. Dre be the name. Still running the game. Still got it wrapped like a mummy. Still ain't tripping. Love to see young blacks get money. Spend time out the hood. Take their moms out the hood. Hit my boys off with jobs. No more living hard. Barbecues every day. Driving fancy cars. Still gonna get my regard.
Look at these emotes.
Still hitting them corners in them lolos, girl. Still taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the D.R.E. I'm representing for the gangsters all across the world. Still hitting them corners in them lolos, girl. Still taking my time to perfect the beat.
Ryu Champ.
I still got love for the streets. It's the D.R.E. I'm representing for the gangsters all across the world. Still hitting them corners in them lolos, girl. Still taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the D.R.E. Like that? Right back up in you. 9-5 plus 4 pennies. Add that shit up. D-R-E. Right back up on top of things. Smoke some with your dog. No stress, no seeds, no stems, no sticks. Some of that real sticky, icky, icky. Ooh-wee. Put it in the air, air, air. Boy, use a fool, D-R.
Doom 3 is 17 years old today. Nice. Who played Doom 3? Older than XQC's chat? Not wrong. I like Doom 3. And I liked Doom 3 even having to switch to the flashlight and back.
give me some brew and I might just chill. But I'm not,
I'm not saying, look, Doom 2 is one of my favorite games of all time, okay? I forgot what I was going to say. Oh. I had a friend with a good computer when that game came out 17 years ago. When would that have been? 2004? Maybe late 2003? My computer could not run a game like that. I remember seeing it, and he had like a sound system, dude. He turned the lights off in his room and fucking booted up Doom 3. Damn. And he had headphones, too. And they were like good headphones. So I put them on. I was like, damn. It was actually really scary. I did not see the 2005 Doom movie. Old Doom games or new Doom games? Look, man. Doom Eternal. Then Doom 2. Then Doom 1. Hold on, no. Doom Eternal. Then Doom Wads that use the super shotgun. Then Doom 2. Then Doom 1. Then Doom 3. I didn't like Doom 2016 all that much. Oh, shit, I forgot about 64. Hold on. Doom Eternal. Doom Wads that have the super shotgun. Doom 2, Doom 64, Doom 1. Probably Doom 2016, then Doom 3. Yeah. Doom 64 is tight. Doom 64 is another game that scared me when I was a kid. Let me show you why it scared me. Imagine, okay? Imagine, it's 1998, you're 8 years old, okay? I sit alone in my four-cornered room staring at candles. And you use cheat codes to unlock the bonus levels in Doom 64 because you're impatient and you're a kid. And then you click this level. It literally starts off with the cyber demon. I already showed the same thing. I know. Yeah. Yep. And there's just like fucking monsters in the wall and shit. You can't even see them because it's Doom 64, so everything's all foggy and shit. You just hear the footsteps of the cyber demon slowly getting closer to you. No armor pickup. Listen. And he teleports randomly. Or rather, there's teleport tiles that he could step on to teleport him. Bro, how many rockets, bruh? Pistol and Billy. Take him out. Nice. I feel like that Cyber Demon had more HP than... Damn. Thank you. They have resistance to rockets? Oh, I knew that. Yeah, I've seen the Decino's videos. It's okay, Sasquatch. Nice name. Did I like Turok 2? I did like Turok 2. And then, I think, I also like Turok 3. I played a lot of multiplayer Turok 3, I think. Yeah, the one where you could be the Velociraptor. Yeah. That's the one I played the most of. Now I'm getting all nostalgic about these old shooters. My video games. My video games. Wait, the Back 4 Blood beta is gonna have the PvP mode? Oh shit. Oh shit. I played Command & Conquer. I played the first one in Red Alert. Remember the first time playing Quake? Yeah. I actually played Quake 2 before I played Quake 1. Because I didn't really have a computer. I actually played Quake 2 on the PC. I don't know why I got Quake 2 instead of Quake 1. I played CS. I think I played CS before 1.6. I played UT 2004. Not as much as I wanted to. I played Unreal Tournament 1 more. Quake 3. Quake 3 was probably my favorite. This isn't the map that I remember, actually. It was the CTF map. Oh, I found it. Mm-hmm. What the F is this? This one. Yeah.
You have the flag.
Riot.
The enemy has your flag. Your team has the enemy flag. Blue flag return.
This guy's an objective gamer, dude. In my memory, it looked 100 times better. This looks better than I remember. So. Which character did I use in Quake? I used the Doom guy. I think his name was Phobos. Phobos is the dude in yellow armor? Did I head swap? I don't know what that is. But I assume not. Did I play Among Us? Yeah, on the Disney Channel. New Among Us TV show! Let's go! Ryu Champ. Put another character's head on someone else's body? Oh. It's the first one, Turtles. Jason, thanks for subbing. Why did you murder A1 Sauce in cold blood in 2019? I love A1 Sauce. What do you mean? I love A1. When Whoops is at my house, he brought a Wagyu steak, A5 or whatever. And he sous-vided it, and then we finished it on my grill. And all I could think about when I was taking a bite was, man, I wish I had some A1 for this bitch. Just a little dab. God, my mouth is watering just thinking about it. A1 makes my mouth water, dude. I don't know what it is. Salt? No, we ended up using, I have this special Korean salt. I forget what it's called. It comes in a jar, a small jar. And we finished it with that. It was really good. It's not mayonnaise. It's not bamboo salt. It has a special name. It might be MSG, actually. I'm trying to find it online. I can't. Rifta, thanks for getting 5 subs. Mercy, thanks for subbing. Yeah, I saw that Espresso Master. You ever think MSG was terrible for you? Yeah, because it was some racist shit that was pushed by boomers. Because they hated China. Am I interested in Elder Souls? Maybe. Apparently MSG is healthier than actual salt. Really? Yeah, someone messaged me that they managed to mod in the dynamic music to the first DLC for Doom Eternal. But not the second one. When does the FF14 story turn good? I enjoyed Shadowbringers. I thought it was a cool concept. Why are you playing an MMO for the story, dude? Go read a book. Heaven's Word was good. Yeah, it's an anime plot, so there's a lot of them being like, just restating stuff constantly. Kanoa, thanks for subbing. Appreciate it. It's like playing RimWorld.
Shut your mouth and look at my wad. Loads of money.
This is a journey.
Split game.
Loads of money.
It's loads of money. Yeah, Splitgate looks like Halo, dude. What the?
Loads of money, probably. Made a right load of finishing knowledge this weekend. Boy, let's watch out for the ladies.
Loads of, loads of, loads of.
You know what I saw in the Halo beta? Grappling hook, baby!
Good evening and welcome to Loads of Money.
Doing up the acid, my bread and butter. My bird's bite's free and my car's a nutter. Loads of money is shall I utter to wave my wad.
Have you played Old Dota like the custom map in Warcraft 3? Bro, I used to only play custom maps in Warcraft 3 when I was a kid. For like a day. Or a year. Not a day. My favorites were Enfos, which I got my Discord friends into. They didn't know the gospel of Enfos before I was like, we should play this game. Almost every tower defense. Hero Line Wars. I like Orc Gladiators, but that was kind of, I never played it when it was back in the day. Yeah, Hero Defense. I played Legion TD.
Onslaught TD still top.
I never played Onslaught. What else? Condemn Blizzard now? Why would I condemn Blizzard for custom games when they had basically nothing to do with it?
Whop your wad on the counter. Whop your wad on the counter. Whop your
They literally had, they were like, you know the editor we use to make all of our campaign maps and multiplayer maps? Well, you guys can use that to make maps too. That's literally all they did. And fucking John Carmack, no, it was John Romero, made an editor for Doom in the fucking early 90s, because that's what they had to do to make their game. So it was as easy as that being like, you guys can use this now. I liked Vampirism. I'm not interested in the Ascent. So here's what I foresee us doing. We're gonna play Back for Blood for a while if it's good. Probably even if it's not good. And that's on Thursday. You didn't hear about the Blizzard Activision lawsuit? Yeah, dude. What? Also, doesn't Back for Blood start on Thursday, Chad? It's the 5th, right? What was that game where you reset your story to further progress? You mean the one where, like, you're getting hunted by the same people or some shit? I don't know. My MMR in Dota 2 in like 2015, I think. It was very low. It was like 3.5. Okay. That's the only time I ever had an MMR in Dota. .5 or 3.2. It's like plat. Nah, it's like worse than plat. That was when 7K was a big deal, so literally like half of 7K. Yeah, I was the plat in the chat. Bam. And when I calibrated, I played with a guy who only played unconventional supports, and that was the number of times I had Invoker support in 2015 where it was very high, and he wasn't a good Invoker player either. Just like other like random shit. He did an anti-mage support once. Basically, anyone with like a stun. I know anti-mage didn't have a stun, but I believe you mean the Intoker. Yeah, utility Invoker. Yeah, literally position for anything, dude. And then he would get mad when we lost, which I understand because I got mad when I lost too. But usually it wasn't his fault. It was our fault because we were trash. You can play anything support in Dota, usually. You think XQC will win the lawsuit? I think he's going to back out because people on the internet said his lawyer's bad. You know how it be, chat. Also, what did I tell you guys, man? Why would you First of all, let's talk about talent agencies. Why the fuck do you have a talent agency, dog, when you're a video game streamer? Why? Why? One, two. Man, I'm getting mad. Woo! They're all leeches, man. They're like fucking, they're Lyme disease administering ticks that try to suck the life out of people who basically hit the lottery, dog. They avail to make themselves useful in weird and peculiar ways to appeal then to the inherently lazy nature of someone who is willing to stream video games for fucking 60 hours a week. They're tumors. Management agencies, people who market themselves to video game streamers, anyone who is an auxiliary part and not essential part of your experience, they are tumors. What about Devin? Devin knows how I feel about managers. Bam, 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 bam. He agreed with me. But on the same hand, these managers, they have a very distinct purpose, once again, for people too lazy to do their own shit. And eventually, if you get big enough, you will need some kind of thing like that, but that's such a small number of video game streamers that ever get big enough to truly require someone like that. And the worst part is the weird network of these people that, like, say someone blows up on Twitch, and then they're like, someone like is like, hey man, you should check these guys out. And then it's like, boom, evolved. Or like, what was the other one that dissolved because the sexual harassment shit? So they'll just recommend each other, and it's like some weird human centipede where they attach the newest streamer's mouth to the asshole of whatever rep that they get from that company. Yeah, look. If the lawsuit goes bad, the effects could set precedent that affects many. Look, man. I'll tell you what, okay? I think I'll be able to live not streaming a major television network stuff on my Twitch stream. I think I can live with that. Even if it was like explicitly, you can't do this or you'll go to jail. Guess what? Never done it. And guess what? I could probably continue not doing it. That's all I'm saying. The new victory in RimWorld requires that you start from scratch 2 times. I'm okay with that. I gotta plant my dryad tree. Here's my advice for a big video game streamer who thinks that they need a manager. Start dating and find someone that will help you manage your business. Find your true love and then have them take care of it for you. Fuck. free labor. Have some kids and then make them inherit the burden and make them do it. Sigma male grind set. Yeah. My wife doesn't really help with, I mean, I don't really do things that require external help. She's helping me with merch. We're still working on it. We want it to be good. But, like, apart from that, I literally don't do anything that would require the assistance of a man. Damn, bruh. Main Blood's becoming the network of streamers that just build on top of each other. Yeah, it's like people love crossovers, man. They love that shit. I would never base my stream solely off of you know, doing stuff with other people though. Imagine all you gotta do is just talk to other people. You don't need But if that's what you want to do, that's what you... Nothing wrong with it. I'm not watching a roleplay right now, chat. I'm over it all. Cease asking me questions about it. I might be into it again in a couple of months. That makes me really sad. Well, guess what? I don't give a shit. Especially because I'm a man who enjoys variety in food, in the games that I play, in the stuff that I watch. So I'm sorry you feel sad that I have a based take on life that has been routinely preached by even the most ancient philosophers from Greece, from Rome, who declared to the heavens and the gods above, variety is the spice of life. Not, why aren't you watching GTA roleplay for 4 years straight, nonstop on Twitch without watching anyone else? Why not? You know who never said that? Socrates. Guess what? I know that, because it was never in a book. You should be happy for me. It's better to have loved than to have lost. Wait, is that how that goes? Than to have never loved at all. Bam, 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 bam. Better to have loved and lost than to have never loved at all. That's what it is. I think. I don't know. I forget. Yeah, it's a Men in Black quote. Shouts to Will Smith, baby. I've played Project Zomboid. It is fun. Socrates once told Plato while dying from hemlock, play Lisa. No, they didn't. Oh my god, new chug video. He's chugging G Fuel. Did you guys know that G Fuel can totally help you stay up for 28 hours to do a stream and appear like you have energy the whole time? Damn, G Fuel's tight. Let's go. It was totally G Fuel.
Well, folks,
we're back. We're doing a chug, and then we begin.
Inspired by Sanic, okay? Hoo-hoo, it is G Fuel. Chili dog flavor. Oh, yeah. Don't touch that mouse. You're watching Badlands Chugs. What's good, folks, and welcome back to Badlands Chugs, okay? Today, we're chugging a very special drink. This, my friends, is G Fuel Chili Dog flavor, all right? It's inspired by the internet meme Sanic, and oh my gosh, it's a new, brand new flavor, okay? And I'm excited to chug it. We're gonna do the official unboxing and the taste test and the chug. So without further ado, let's get on with it. Yeah. All right. Here we go, folks. This is G Fuel Chili Dog flavor. Oh, yes. Sugar-free, 15 calories, 40 servings. Oh, it's good for me. Good enough for me, all right? And this is all the stuff in the back. That's enough, all right? Buy it and you can read it, all right? And we also got a G Fuel cup, okay? Yes, and Sanic is on it, all right? We about to do this. Let's put this box over here. Now let's open this bad boy. Open. Safety tab. And I love it. Every time you open a fresh tub of G Fuel, that smell. And this is what it looks like, folks. Oh, yes. And let's not waste no time. Let's open this. And they got the little, I don't need that. All right. But let's put the water in. Put a nice scoop, 15 calorie scoop of G Fuel. Yeah. Close it up. And now it's time to shake this bad boy, okay? You ready? Let's go. And now we about to try it, all right? Pop this top, and I would like to give this toast to G Fuel, okay? Thank you for sponsoring, and thank you for allowing Badlands Chugs to test out your newest flavor, all right? Enough talk, let's get it. Cheers, folks. Mmm, taste like chili dogs. How did they get that taste of a chili dog into a drink? Man, all right. I can roll with that. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. But you know, here at Badlands Chucks, this size is nowhere near enough, okay? So, you know how we gotta do this. We gotta put it in the big wine glass, all right? Let's do a real G Fuel chili dog chuck, okay? Let's go. Let's put some. This is the real G Fuel Chug, okay? Chili dog flavor on Badlands Chugs. Big ups to G Fuel for sponsoring, and we about to do this. Badlands Chug style. Enough talk. Let's get it, folks. Cheers. Yeah! Woo! That's what it is. That's what it's all about. Yes, I feel like playing some Sonic, okay? Woo-hoo! Ah, love this chili dog flavor. It is so good. Get you some G Fuel chili dog, okay? If you use my code Badlands, get 30% off your favorite G Fuel, okay? Big ups to G Fuel. Love y'all. And I am out. Peace, y'all.
Chugging the world one bottle at a time. Badlands Chugs is back.
Sleepka. Awokega. Everyone who's subbed, thanks for subbing. If I miss it, DM me on Discord and I will thank you personally. I should watch the G Fuel video for myself. Why? We'll be right back. Richie, thanks for subbing. Appreciate it. What up? Yo, dog. All right. So the reason I wanted to do this stream is simple, and it might be hard because we currently have a colony going. I don't think that should matter, though. It's because I always look at every time
How
I look over chat
to teach our children about this game if you have no clue what you are doing yourself. The only thing you are fit to teach is how to eat.
That's a good disclaimer. I'm not good at RimWorld. However, I can teach you how to not lose immediately. The reason I want to do this is because I always look at chat and they're like, I like watching this, but I don't know what's happening. It's very, very easy. Very easy. Most of the time. So we just got attacked, and they used frag grenades to breach my wall, and then I gunned them down in this room. These are their corpses, which I assigned with a stockpile, but we'll get to that, boys. First, we're gonna discuss, what's the objective of RimWorld? What even is the objective? Every time I watch your stream, you're just dead. What's happening? I don't understand. Why are you dead all the time? And the answer to that is simple. It's because I play in a very hard difficulty, okay? RimWorld's not this difficult. For like 90% of the people that play it. That's just how it be. The first thing we're going to discuss are our characters. In the start that I chose, I started with three. I'm pretty sure some of my original colonists are dead. They're in a grave over here, I forget. Actually, I think I might have my original colonists, I forget. I don't know. Well, we gotta get this guy out of this plate mail armor because he's moving really slow. RimWorld. I use mods. Pretty sure I have a mod list somewhere in chat. I don't know. Plate armor does slow you down. In fact, a lot of armor does. Most of the time, that's okay. Let's discuss our characters as they are otherwise known pawns. The most important thing you need to realize is the needs tab. Very important. Because if your character is unhappy, they will suffer a mental breakdown and not do anything that you want them to. So you have to manage all of those meters. And they're pretty self-explanatory. If your character's food meter goes down, then they get starving and then malnutritioned and will eventually pass out or go berserk. If they don't sleep, then they'll pass out from exhaustion. If they don't get recreation, then they get really mad. And all of this shit's recreation stuff, like the television, poker table, billiards, harpsichord. They'll also talk to each other and walk around for recreation. And that is the essence of RimWorld. You have to manage all of those things while simultaneously progressing through the text tree to unlock the things that you need to escape the planet or do any of the alternative victories, which I'm not really aware of. Explaining done. Explain the fences? Okay.
can't write fast enough. Will there be a test on this on Friday?
So this shit right here actually doesn't do anything. It used to, but they changed it in the recent edition of RimWorld. This used to slow characters down, and then they couldn't stop and shoot because the AI would try to get to an unoccupied space. So, like, right here is when they would try to shoot. And then they don't have any cover, and they've been getting shot the whole time. So it's a cheese strat? Mm-mm. No, 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 chat. This is a don't die strat, specifically for my difficulty. Ballgazer, thanks for subbing. The important part of this stream is that you should feel free to ask questions, and I will feel free to answer. Right now we're burning corpses, because my colonists hate looking at them and they get very angry. Is that the default way of storing stuff, just laying it around in a big room? Yeah, usually. You can build shit like this, but this only holds two kinds of items, right? So I've got mortar shells down here because these are mortars. Rate my RimWorld base. It's pretty good, man. This is a strip mine. I'm specifically looking for minerals.
Why do you weigh 400 pounds?
I do not weigh 400 pounds. We gotta build this wall right here. He's cleaning. So, let's talk about the beauty of rooms. Very important. If there's dirt on the floor, then it's less beautiful. And dirty. And if you're treating people medically in rooms that are dirty, they have a higher chance of getting infections, which are really deadly. You can amputate infected limbs and they can survive that way, but a lot of the times you get infected on the torso and stuff, and you obviously cannot amputate their torso because they will die. And you know, if something's dirty, it'll look like this or that. Just shit that looks out of place. It'll look like vomit. Isn't this guy really good? Why did I get this guy? Oh, I just need more people. So we're gonna convert this guy
Shout
to our religion.
My boyfriend, Matt Smile, you stink.
Next thing you might have noticed is that all of my characters are wearing the same thing almost. That's because most of them are combatants, and the specific fabric that I use to make this item right here, the duster, is defensible. And they're all wearing helmets and goggles.
Information, but why does chat keep spamming the puking frog?
Shut up. These are our farms. Very important. That's number one tip.
What do you do when your colonists are in a love triangle?
TTS is off now, because it keeps distracting me. Thanks for the money. Hang on. Shut up, bitch. Feel free to donate your text-to-speech messages when I'm not doing something like this. Like yesterday, when I basically got none. Not that I'm complaining about not getting them, but the timing is bad. Okay. Now, where were we? At least on day two, you should plant your farms, because depending on the start that you choose, you start with a certain amount of food, and eventually that food's going to go away. You can also just hunt animals, but depending on which biome you're in, you might not get many animals because they can't survive. I picked a temperate forest mountainous region because I got super fucked the last time I tried to make a mountain base, so I wanted to be able to do something like this without losing first. because I was randoming and I did two or one Savannah start, the Arid Shrubland, Naked Brutality, and my character got eaten by a lion on the first day. And I didn't even have like a structure for them to be in. Just immediately got killed by a lion and literally eaten by the lion. My advice for growing food, if you need food fast, you should grow rice. It yields less, but it's useful for if you only have like one guy, I guess. Even like three guys is probably okay, but you should do a big rice field if that's the case. Rice is more susceptible to blight, which I haven't even seen. And that's just a random event that happens will make your crops, they make them useless, basically. Right now we're playing at normal speed, which I never do. So that I can explain everything. This is our production room. This is where we make stuff. Not really much else to say about that. We got a bunch of shit in here, depending on what we need. Right now I got this guy cutting stone blocks because I want to make walls out of stone because they are not flammable. Also, they're sturdier than normal. This is our hospital. It took a long time for us to research the stuff that we needed, but we were able to make a fully sterile room. Which is very useful when doing surgeries and treating people and having them recover from their various diseases, which... That's a big part of RimWorld, is getting randomly plagued, or blight, or, flu, or sensory mechanites, or, what's the one that gives you the 20% pain? And it usually happens in one big wave, where, like, half of your colonists will, or, like, usually, like, a third will get this stuff, and then they'll basically be useless. Or less than useful. And you make stock zones and dumping zones. Oh yeah, let's talk about zones real quick, boys. Once you figure this shit out, it makes the game a lot easier. You start by making a stockpile zone. It has settings by default. You can find them by clicking the storage tab. Default settings for stockpile zones are usually not sufficient at all, right? Because it starts with the default stockpile having food go to it, which obviously we don't want to do that because food rots if it's not frozen. This is our freezer. Also, we've got a corpse in here because we're going to revive this guy later. But when you first start, all you have to do is just drop a regular stockpile zone and then haul all of the shit that you start with to that stockpile zone just to get it secure. Because you start with these things right here, the package survival meal, at least in the original start. And wild animals will walk up and eat your food. So you end up with like less than you should have if it's not like in a walled off room with a door. At that point, building stuff out of wood is usually acceptable, but you typically want to move it into a stone building. But the important thing... And, God, where's a good example of this? You can customize everything about a stockpile, okay? And the most important tab is right here, priority. The higher the priority, obviously they're going to bring stuff to this first. So in this case, I have a stockpile dedicated to ratty clothes, because if clothing is below 50% quality... Your people get a mood debuff from wearing it. And it's easily avoidable to just remove it and then drop it and then set up a stockpile to have all of the old clothing brought to... we use a crematorium. I think you can burn it on a campfire too. But the reason I bring that up is because this is critical priority. Okay. Which means we have another stockpile over here that accepts clothing. In fact, it accepts the same kind of clothing as this one, but the priority is lower. But also, I've customized it so that everything below 50% hit points gets brought here. Okay, so I could probably even bring bring this priority down to normal and have it be the same as this, and then the stuff that we want to burn would still get brought over here because we customized this part right here. And that's the essence of stockpiles. Another good example is I've got a fridge with a bunch of meals in it. Okay, a freezer. We'll call it a freezer. Believe it or not, these act as walls, in case you're curious. And I'm pretty sure these are from mods, so if you don't have these on your game, that's probably why. They don't really do anything, actually, because of the way that we prepare food, but... basically, I have it set up in such a way that all of the excess food goes in here, and that these refrigerators near my dining table and the prisoner room get filled up first. And I did that by assigning the priority. So the fridges have critical priority, and this has important priority. Does that make sense? Show them how a freezer works using the AC. So I got a cooler here. Okay. And note these, the blue square and the red square. That's the game telling us which direction is getting cold air and which direction is getting hot air, because it produces hot air. obviously, we want our freezer to be cooled, so we put a cooler in there. The bigger the room, the more coolers you will need. And once you make a cooler, this is very important, you have to set the target temperature, because it starts at 70 degrees Fahrenheit for whatever reason. So I bring mine down to 38, minus 38. Similarly, we have heaters to heat rooms. These don't have any exhaust, so you can just drop them down, and they try to bring the temperature to about 70 by default, which is typically what you want. I think it's around like 82 degrees Fahrenheit when people start to get mad that they're sleeping in the heat or whatever. What is power management? Okay, that's a good one. You start the game with a wind turbine, or being able to make a wind turbine, but you can't make any batteries. Batteries store the power. So in theory, right at the gate, you could build a wind turbine and then run a power line to whatever you want to power. And whenever the wind's blowing, you'll have power, but there's no excess power. So as soon as the wind's not blowing, stuff is going to start turning off. So what I do is I research batteries, which is one of the first things you can research. Right here. And usually I do it kind of late, because I'm just trying to set up my defenses and trying to survive. But once you have batteries, these are the batteries right here. You just run a power line from the batteries to the wind turbine, and then you run a line to whatever you want to power. And I like to have two, but I end up not being able to have two because of the way that I set up my room. So I've got these solar generators also doing it, and they're just constantly generating power. And I actually have my lines are redundant in case some of those get broken. All the blue lines are power lines. And this is not a good setup by any means. But, we've had a lot of raids fuck this up. So eventually, I was thinking about last night. We're going to build another geothermal generator. And you build these over geothermal vents. They look like little geysers, I guess. And they're the best form of power generation for a long time. Not necessary by any means. But what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to run a line and then make it redundant a third time, so that even if all of this shit gets broken, and I'm going to have some batteries too over here. Even if it gets broken, it'll still be good, so. Nice. Right now, my dudes are sleeping. And basically, that's about it. You just try to survive and get to the, whatever victory you're trying to do. And manage your pawns' moods and whatnot. Right now, our base is kind of ugly because we did not have any stone blocks. How do you assign tasks? Oh, good, good fucking. So this looks daunting, right? Right? But this is how it looks at first. And the very first thing I do when I start a game is I'll click the work tab. I'll click manual priorities. And the way that it works is it's left to right. So all of the ones, that's the most important thing that they'll try to do. And it starts from the left. Okay, so if there's no fires to fight, then they'll be a patient. If they're not wounded, then they'll go to bed rest. And if they are still not wounded, then they'll do haul plus, which is a mod that I have to urgently haul stuff if I need it. Very highly recommend that. It's the allow tool mod. And then basic is like switch flipping and stuff, like turning stuff on and off. And then everything after that typically depends on their own skills. And every pawn is different. So, like, you'll notice the different shades of the boxes and stuff. That's the game telling us how good they are at that particular thing at a glance. This is the color for 3, and then this is the color for 20, right? It's like gold and whatnot. And basically, you try to figure out what you need, and then have your pawns do what you gotta do. And typically, when you get around, like, 4 or 5 people, you'll start having, like, one guy who's just, like, exclusively hauling stuff, which is good. Or even, like, from the beginning, if you really need it. The red border means that I have them doing something that they're not good at. So the game's warning me that they suck. How to recruit prisoners? So if you're using the new DLC ideology... you need to capture them, right? And usually you can capture people or arrest them at any point. As long as you draft your unit, so you just select someone, then hit R, and then they're drafted, right? And you have to have a room dedicated to prisoners. So you by doing that, like, if you need one in a snap, you can do something like this. This is a good example. This is an empty room. If you have someone you really want to capture, just drop one of these sleeping spots in a room that is not occupied or used often. And it can be small, too. Doesn't have to be big. Case in point, I've got these conversion chambers where I put people I want to convert their religion in. And these count as their own rooms because they're walled off and doored off. And you drop one of these... sleeping spots, and you go to 4 colonists, you change it to 4 prisoners, boom. And then, when you have someone drafted, or you can even do it when they're not drafted, you just right-click the person you want to kidnap, and then select capture, and then they'll bring them to an unoccupied prisoner bed. From there, you go to the prisoner tab, and if you're playing ideology, you need to convert them to your religion first, otherwise they will get... actually, it depends on... It depends on the memes that you chose. Some of your, there are some religions that don't care if they follow other religions, but I play ones that do, usually. So you want to convert them to your religion so it's easier to manage everybody. Because each religion has different things that, they want. So you want to convert them first, and basically, when you select convert, the person who has the warden task enabled will routinely go in there and talk to them to convert them. In this case, my religion's leader, moral guide, our leather man, is also the warden, which is convenient because we can walk over and use her convert skill. And we reduced it by a large amount because she's really good at social, which is what determines your ability to recruit people or lower their resistance and whatnot. And then periodically she goes over here. That's her talking to her. Him. And then eventually it happens. It goes faster if you have them in a... The conversion seems to go faster when they're in these tiny rooms. I don't know if that's true or not. Where you going, buddy? Let's go punch this, boom rat. Oh, God. You know what? It's time for you to get some scars, boy. Oh, nice. We're good. Now it won't blow up on him because it passed out. But it will blow up eventually when it dies. Yeah, there are different AI directors. I'm using Randy Random. What are good defenses to make when you first start? Something that looks like this. Typically out of stone, you can do wood, but eventually, like, tribes people especially like to set wood walls on fire, so it'll just break them. And what I do... is, I fill them with spike traps, which you should know by default. Unless you're a tribe starter, I think. But they also might know it by default, I'm not sure. And you just fill them. And you typically want to fill them, one at a time, because your character, if they walk over traps, they have a chance of triggering them. The safe way to do this is 2x2 instead of 1x1. But 1x1's more efficient for killing people. And then you set a door to just completely bypass this part of the base. So your guys can use the door, but anyone who's attacking you will go through this open entrance and just walk over spike traps. Does that make sense, Billy? AI directors determine the pace of the game. I have the one that's random. Yeah, or you can put doors between the traps like this. I use steel spike traps because wooden traps do less damage, and you usually have access to a lot of steel. But also it's really wasteful. But one steel spike trap will usually incapacitate somebody. And I think it's two wooden traps to do it. You do something like this where they just walk through the traps. And then, you know, chill like that. What's the best way to make a kill box? I don't know, I'm not good at it. I would recommend looking up what a picture of it looks like. Or Chump, thanks for subbing. You show us character traits. Look at a character, click bio. Here are their traits. When you kidnap people and try to recruit them, you should be looking at these traits every time. Otherwise, you'll end up with someone who's like a pyromaniac or like something really undesirable. Yeah, and their health. You want to look at their traits and their health, because they might have something like asthma, you know, which is a permanent affliction, or dementia, which is usually means because they're elderly or whatever. How to deal with sappers? You just have to adapt in the moment. I got sapped right here. They blew that wall up, and then they walked over here and blew this up with grenades. And then I ended up opening this door right here and then fighting the... I took cover behind the statues, and I killed, like, 15 guys just, like, right here. You can also do something like, I think sappers favor man-made walls, so they won't try to blow up these walls ever, but they might go for this because this is a wall that I made. So what you can do is set IEDs, I guess. What's the number in parentheses next to their age? I think if they were in cryo sleep, that's how old they actually are. So that's just a character that has been in cryo sleep before. It doesn't matter at all. But I keep mining structures and squares but don't do anything with them. Because I don't need to, really. Eventually we will use all of these rooms, but right now they're just kind of like temporary. Oh yeah, you can age reverse, yeah. Bam, bam, bam. Do old people work slower? If they have an affliction, they do. But them just being old doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to work slower. They have to have, like, a bad back or something, which you can see in the health tab. Are traits more important than attributes when you're choosing who to recruit? I like to look at traits first. But if you really need someone who's, like, good at shooting, then you could probably deal with a negative trait. Forcing orders on pawns. Oh yeah, that's another thing. You can directly control your pawns. It's not very efficient. So you want to get good at managing their work so that they're always doing what you want them to be doing. Well, like this guy, I got him crafting first, but he's also a miner, right? But because he has the miner work enabled, I can select him and then right click this and then have him mine it. But because it's not prioritized, he'll just walk away and start trying to craft again. So you can right click and then hold down shift and then right click again. It's like shift queuing in an RTS. It's useful if you need it done fast. Gotta make a wall. Also gonna make a door right here. A stone door. I try to have all of my external doors be stone because they're not flammable. Wooden doors are. I have tried to have all of my interior doors be wooden because they open faster than stone doors. Does prioritizing actions affect moods? No. Unless it's something that they inherently already hate. How long have I played RimWorld? I think I only have like 300 hours in it. Why do I have 400 fences in the kill box? Because I thought it would make them move slower. It doesn't. In fact, I might just get rid of all this shit. The devs changed the way that moving over this stuff works. We're gonna leave them in here. Also, this wall's kind of fucked up. Go down here, Sugma. They still slow down when they first climb it? Yeah, but if they're on top of it, already climbing, then they don't slow down anymore. So the only useful one is like this one right here. So what we're gonna do actually is a new strat in this edition, which isn't good, by the way. You should only do it to slow them down. And I'll explain why you shouldn't do it out here. How many is there? Only four, really. Yep, I'm an idiot. I meant to make it right here. We actually have to force him to get rid of all these fences because right now they can be used as cover. Cover is something very important in combat. Extremely important in combat. Which is why I have it set up like this up here, but I'll explain that in a second. See how it slowed him down on the first one, but not the other ones? So what we're gonna do, and this is a convenience thing to give us more time. When we're being raided. I get this shit out of here. We're gonna do something like this. So they're constantly having to climb over it. And I recommend fences for this because they're really cheap. So this will slow all of them down when they're coming in. Bam, 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 bam. I think that works. I'm not sure. Basically just trying to make it a pain to get in. And then we fill this area up because no one can stand here and shoot. And shooting around a wall, it gives you the most cover in the game, I'm pretty sure. Which is why we'll position people like right here. And then they'll peek out and then shoot whatever they can see. So basically, we don't want them to be able to stand around these corners. Because from here, they can't shoot any of my guys that would be defending. But from here, they probably could. So we just filled it up with fences until it would force them out in the actual kill box. And they might be able to use this as cover, but it won't really matter. Because fences give shitty cover anyway. It's only 25% a wall. Gives you 75%. And what that exactly means, I don't know, but. We're gonna set up a. I'll teach you guys how to add bills and stuff. The stone chunks give cover. Yeah, we're gonna be moving those out. All of this stuff's getting removed. Bam, 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 bam. We're gonna leave these in here because I think I don't think it matters actually, but we gotta remove all of this shit. Some of the other things I did in this to make this effective is I put a roof on it, which actually I should probably remove the roof further down. Because if you're outside in the rain trying to shoot, it lowers your accuracy. But up here, I have a roof for sure because, you know, I don't want my guys being rained on while they're defending. So actually, we're going to go in and remove the roof here from the zone section. We want to leave it over our turrets as well. You need a roof when you're building inside of a cave? Depends on the cave. If it's a mountain, you can tell based on the bottom left. If you hover over an empty spot that says overhead mountain, that counts as a roof. And the way that you can tell if a place is properly sealed off is if it'll say outdoors. In the bottom right here. So, you know, this is complete. I didn't build a roof here at all. You know, there's not even any roof for me to remove. But because it's under the mountain, there is a roof. Mm. Can drop pods with enemies drop below a roof? They can go through roofs. I don't think they can go through mountains, though. But living in a mountain gives you the chance to get infested, so it's a trade-off. Let's talk about bills. Very important. These are production tables. They all do different things. Let's talk about forever bills. Very important. If you have someone who's like good at art, and the only thing they're good at is art, you're going to set up a... I like to do large sculpture, and I typically only like to let them do it out of stone. So what I'll do is I'll do forever. I'll go here. I'll let them take it to the best stockpile, which is this one right here. It's the silly one that allows statues. And then I will go over here and select which ones, what kind of stone blocks I want them to use in the construction. Stone art's the best because stone's typically renewable, or at least there's a lot of it. Whereas with trees, you can run out of trees if you use all your wood. Especially, you're gonna waste all your wood if you're making art. Marble is the most beautiful stone. Granite's the strongest stone. I'm not sure if using marble in art actually gives it a bonus, but it's also the weakest stone, I think. So it's best suited for art and decorations and shit. So I just selected marble. I only want large sculptures made forever out of marble. The next important thing is the ingredient radius. This makes it so that they will only pull from nearby stockpiles. Or whatever is within range of this little thing that increases and decreases. So I only want the person making art to be pulling from stone block piles near the table, because I don't want them running across the entire map to go get like one stone block or some shit. And this philosophy applies to basically every production build that you use or do. You typically want ingredients close to what you're making. So, this is the stone cutter table, which is what we make blocks out of, and we make blocks out of chunks. And you get chunks when you mine stone, or they're just scattered around the map. I also have a forever bill on this. This will probably always be a forever bill. Well, let's make a new one right now so I can show you. I want granite because I want some of my external walls to be replaced with granite because I have marble walls right now and they're kind of weak. This is a luxury thing. Marble walls are typically sufficient. But I need some extra granite. So I'm going to add a bill. Make granite blocks do forever. I'm going to make this the first bill. It goes from top to bottom, so they're going to do the top one first if they can. And I only want to pull from that big old stone chunk stockpile up there. So I'm going to bring it into like right about there. And for stone cutting, I like to just drop it on the floor so that the guy cutting the blocks, there's less downtime. And whoever I have hauling can come over and just move the blocks to wherever they need to go. And I'm done. I did it. Important. How do you filter your storage locations to have specific things? You click on a stockpile, go to storage. Priority is the most important thing here. All stockpiles start at normal. I have this one set to important. And then you just go through and you check off what you want to be stored there. And if you have two different stockpiles that are storing the same thing, but you want them to go to one place first, you need to raise the priority of the stockpile that you want stuff brought to first to be above whatever the other one is. So if the one you don't want it to go to is important, then you want to set the one that you do want it to go to critical so that it goes to critical first. Slick Meister, thanks for subbing. Recommend a mod that lets you save stockpiles and bills for future runs? That sounds like a good idea. What about animals? The thing that lets you tame animals depends on your handle skill. And you can actually buy animals or have animals that your characters cannot handle. Which I actually had a problem with this run, because my animal handler died. And then they broke my animal pens, and I had animals I couldn't bring back to the pen because my guys weren't good enough to do it. But basically, every animal has a minimum handling skill, which is in the info somewhere. You'll know if you can't do it when you just go, like, you can click on it and then click tame, and then it will tell you that you don't have the skill to handle that animal. If you want to tame an animal, you can find it on the map and then select tame. Or you can go to wildlife. This is a list of all the animals on the map that aren't yours. And you can just go through and, this is hunt. This is the tame column. I have some animals marked to be tamed. And then you just select that. And the game will tell you if you can't do it. Next, you need an animal pen. Which is an enclosed space. And once you have the enclosed space, this is a weird shape. And also, honestly, this is a shitty pen. But once you have something like this, and you can use fences. Some animals are too big for fences. But fences are cheap and they're built quick. So, like, animals that are like alpacas and shit, or like donkeys, those are things you can fence off. But, like, the gigantelope, this animal right here will just walk over fences. So you need walls. And walls function the same way as fences for smaller animals, in that they're honestly the best thing that you can make. And I like to wait until I have a walled off area instead of a fenced off area, because it protects them from raids too. Because normal humans can walk over fences. So they'll just walk over and kill your animals, because fuck them. That's another thing. Also, wall off your farms as soon as you can. Because tribalists especially like to set them on fire. A lot. And yeah, you need to set them to not have a roof as well, because they need sunlight to grow. So after you have something like this, your guy might start automatically building a roof. You just gotta go to remove roof area and then highlight it. This area already doesn't have a roof because of how big it is, I think. But we can just do this for fun. You only need to unroof the tiles that stuff's being grown in. But you can do the whole structure if you wanted. Boom. I have this unroofed. I don't know why I have this. Oh yeah, to vent it. This puts out a lot of heat. So I had to unroof this so that it wouldn't blow up. And yeah. Try to build a walled off area. And once you build a walled off area, you have to go to Architect and then go to Miscellaneous. And then get Pen Marker. And you have to put a pen marker down. And this makes it so that your people who handle animals know exactly where to take animals, and they won't take them anywhere other than a place with a pen marker in it. Boom. Animals produce like leather and milk and shit. How do you handle expansion? You find you redo a lot of shit mid-game? Yeah, I've already done a couple of these rooms. I just move shit around. It takes a while, but you can do it. Can wire conduits go into mountain walls? No. You have to smooth a wall to do that. So that's why I'm running it on the floor, because I'm lazy. Otherwise, you could, honestly, this is probably the safest way to do conduits, because if you have, like, a sapper might, like, if I replace these walls with normal walls, which is the fast way of doing it, of running a line through a wall, a sapper might come through and just randomly blow it up and then break the line, right? But a sapper isn't going to walk up and break power lines on the ground for whatever reason. Oh, hell yeah. Oh, wait, we're not going to be able to skin all of these. Oh, Jesus. So we're being attacked. Right now, I'm double-clicking all my dudes at the top here to see where they're at. See if anyone's about to get run over outside. It looks like we were fortunately able to have all of our guys inside. And I'm going to give this guy, who has one shooting, a sniper rifle, because sniper rifles have very high accuracy. Otherwise, he might be useless shooting a gun. Now I'm going to very carefully watch all of these guys to make sure none of them run outside. They're the little dots moving around. And once they get close enough, I'm going to draft literally everybody once again to make sure that they don't run outside and die. And then once I have everyone drafted, I like to right-click and drag. Hold on, I'm gonna fix that. Boom. Uh-oh. Ah, shit. Wait, no, they're not gonna... Oh, no. We might be able to get this in time again. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're quickly gonna build a wooden wall here. It should be fine. No way. Ah, poop. All right. It's time to be Hero Sugma. There's a hole in my base. That's very bad. I think we don't have enough firepower to stop these guys in their tracks. Wait, why did I make it there? Oh my god, I'm an idiot. I should have made it right here. So we can fight them, or... I need this to be broken. What's your land speed? 4.8? 3.6? Why are you so slow, bruh? Oh, I think it's his leg slowing him down. We're gonna hold that door open. Am I an idiot? Uh-oh. Why aren't you going that way? No! Alright, hopefully he doesn't die from this. We're good. Oh, we're very good. I was gonna kite them through the thing, but I fucked up and I had a trap right here, so it was preventing it from, like, notice how I moved them all away from the other entrances? I was just gonna have them run through here and just run all the elephants through it. All these elephants got owned. Another thing to note is that a colonist cannot shoot some another colonist that is directly next to them, I think. Pretty sure that's how it works. Within two. So, you know, these guys won't get hit by those guys usually. Alright, I think we got them all. Unfortunately, a lot of them are actually skinnable. We're gonna have our other doctor go rescue our other doctor. Where is Punch'em at? Punch'em's gonna start punching him. Because that's what he does. When a corpse is dark red like that, it means that they can't be skinned. So our character got fucked up. And there's a couple of things that suck about that. One, he's gonna be out of commission for a little bit. Two... Depending on the kind of damage he took, it's going to do damage to his equipment. And obviously, once this gets below 50%, he gets a mood debuff, so eventually we're going to have to ditch this duster because it's really valuable. And this cloth broad wrap especially is going to have to go. But we can make a Devil Strain one, I believe. No, we can't. But we've got a good doctor. And for wounds like this, I'm not sure if it matters. When you see someone with bruises and cracks, a bruise and a crack cannot get infected. However, a stab wound can, or cut. Or anything that's like a piercing wound or a slashing wound, especially if you don't have a hospital room, it's good to leave them on bed rest in a clean room so that they have a lower chance of getting an infection. Hospital rooms themselves have multiple ways that they reduce infections. Namely, the immunity gain speed factor and the hospital bed that I have. I researched all of this. Infection chance multiplier from room, so it is 0.2 times a normal infection rate, I believe. So it's reduced by a lot. So, as that is the case, and even though we have a lot of medicine, because this character is so good and because he's in a hospital bed, we can actually afford to treat him without medicine. Because the quality is going to be so good because of our skill and the area that they're in. Treating someone without medicine also, I believe, takes longer, so keep that in mind if you're ever trying to treat someone in the field. It might be worth it to just have them rescued and brought closer to medicine that you have. Let's get some elephant leather. Elephant leather is some of the best leather in the game. It might even be better than Devil Strand, but I don't think so. But Devil Strand's not leather, it's something you grow. All of these different kinds of leathers have different defense stats on them. Bam, 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 bam. Devil Strand's 100% fire protection? I didn't know that. Right now we're just researching random shit. Elephants also produce a lot of leather and a lot of meat. They're very dangerous to hunt though, because they fuck your dudes up. So we're gonna haul urgently this meat. Here's a little tip. If you're lazy like me, if you zoom in just to see only the stuff that you want hauled, you can just double click all that without having to worrying about it selecting stuff that I don't want hauled that's already been hauled. So now Sugma's on bed rest, but because I'm feeling dangerous and because I have such good medical equipment, I'm actually going to put him on bed rest too, which means he's not going to do bed rest because I have other shit that I want him to do. If he gets an infection, he can just go back there. Alright, we'd already almost finished that one, so. So we got a ground penetrating scanner, which we're going to use to help us find minerals. And I believe, where is that? Miscellaneous? Ground penetrating scanner. Sensory unit used by researchers to search for buried resources. Chance to find a resource depends on the operator's research ability. This is a default thing in the game. I think it has to be outside? Question mark? No. Cannot be placed under a roof. Okay. Unroof 3x3. Okay. I don't want to put it over there because it's just going to get broken. You can do it like right here. Yeah. Poggers. Bram, Now we need to mark this as not roofed right away, because it's so small that whoever's constructing this will definitely put a roof on it. For corpses, you want to get them out of your base as soon as possible. Once again, highly recommend using the allow tool mod for that. Most colonists really hate corpses a lot. He's wounded, so he's moving slower. Wait, it has to be unroofed? Am I an idiot? That should be fine. We don't want our guy standing out in the rain while he does that, so we're gonna put a small roof over there for him. Colonists also hate when there's just blood on the floor and shit. It's a random event that takes my power up for a little bit. It has happened many times while I'm being raided. Elephant tusks sell for a lot, I believe. Where's geothermal? Down here. Any questions? Why not use batteries for flares? Can you do that? I don't know. I just kind of take the dick. I don't really give a shit, so. All electronics don't work in flares. That's what I thought. What's that dog tech tree? Animal prosthetics. Right now, we actually need more mortar shells, so I'm going to go over here and I think we've got some chem fuel. Mortar shells are chem fuel and steel, which we've got both of. I use high explosive shells. Let's go ahead and make like 20 of them. All of the stuff is out of here now. Very nice. We have a very small crematorium, so we have to kind of actively... manage it. Oh, we've got a solar flare going on. Frick! So once again, this guy could definitely get, an infection. But we don't really have to fear infections as much as we do in the early game, because we've got a hospital room. Very important. Especially in the difficulty I'm playing on, infection rate goes up really fast. Like, really fast. He said a specific thing to produce something forever. Nah, everything that you produce is made by people, I think. Except maybe nutrient paste? I don't know. For these shells, we're gonna set it so that he drops it on the floor. Because once again, I just want the shells made as soon as possible, so. So he's running back and forth, he's doing it. One thing to note about forcing a colonist to do something like producing stuff is that they will literally do it until they pass out from exhaustion, usually. So be careful about making them produce and just remember to draft them and undraft them to reset what it is they should be doing. Otherwise they will pass out and get very angry, so. Very angry. Another gigantalope, poggers. These are pack animals, and I believe they also produce milk. Also, we're trying to get the borpas. There's pretty rare question words that automatically make stuff. Ooh. I think I'm gonna forbid these steel traps, which means that they won't be auto remade. Because we don't have much steel right now, so. In fact, we don't even have the steel to make our thingy. So we're gonna go mine some steel. This is our miner. He's very poggers. That one trap blueprints near the door? Oh. Goodbye. We're just taming as many animals as we can. Because we have a, such a huge space down here. I wanted to move it up here, but I end up needing more food for my dudes. The higher someone's level is, the faster they usually are at doing their thing. This guy's level 16 miner out of 20. So he's very fast. Another thing to discuss is schedules, which I don't think I've talked about yet. Very important. We're gonna haul urgently that because we need it urgently. So schedules are important. I am by no means a theory crafter when it comes to this shit right here. But what I try to do is give people 7 hours of sleep. Because 8 is excessive, especially if you have high quality beds, it'll make them rest faster. Which we usually end up having because we always have someone who's really good at construction, which is what determines how good it will be when it is done. Some characters are night owls, like Van. Van's a night owl, so he gets a mood debuff when he's awake during the day, the 11th hour through the 18th hour. So I try to mold his schedule around that. This is what a night owl schedule for me looks like. I like them to do recreation at the start of the day and at the end of the day, and they will eat during recreation. Before I was doing this, right here, I was having them do anything for the first hour, and they were just running off into the distance to do like one small thing that they were doing as part of their main tasks, and then not being able to run back in time to do recreation, so they were missing recreation. So basically, right before sleep and right when they wake up, I make them do 3 hours of recreation. That's probably too much. I think you could probably get away with 2. But yeah, for the most part, everyone who is a night sleeper has the same schedule. Everyone who's a day sleeper has the same schedule. It's poggers. Anything between rec and work. I tried that, and the only other thing that would be between rec and work is anything, and they like to default to doing their job. So someone might wake up, and then they have that 1 hour to do anything between recreation and work, and they'll be like, all right. I'm just going to go out here and tame this animal right here. So they'll go all the way out here, miss all of their recreation time, and then start working, and then never do recreation. So. Yeah. Why not make some meditate? I don't have any sidecasters. We're using good old-fashioned bullets. Talk about the difference in meals. You can make simple meals, fine meals, and lavish meals. The fine meals and lavish meals require more ingredients. Right now I'm spamming simple meals because I'm kind of behind on food. I'm waiting for this corn to grow. We got a Gorpa, boys. Some animals are... They aren't, like, yard animals, I guess, and you have to manually choose which zone you want to put them in. So in this case, like, these rams and shit will be brought to the pen no matter what, right? But animals like Gorpa, I have to assign them to a zone or just let them roam around. So I like to make a zone inside of the pen for them as well. Because animals like to produce a lot of filth when they move around. A lot of filth. An astounding amount of filth. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, 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 bam. We don't have to worry about that. Talk about the fake pawns who turn into mobs? You mean mimes? That's a mod that I have. Randomly, you'll get joined by people who are actually aliens, and then they'll just try to kill you. Art almost done. No, you always want to use animals to haul if you can. An epic aunt. Depiction of a town councilor wearing a formal suit moving to the right. Okay. So art's important for making rooms beautiful. Our bedroom's already omega beautiful. 7.88 is very good. You want it around like 5 or 6. And I try to put art in rooms that people are in a lot so that they get a mood buff from it. Look, gorgeous environment, 15. That's a huge deal. That's a huge deal. Especially for researchers, because they're always in the same place. I think I have them hauling right now, though. We gotta get this shit gone, dude. The Arco Nexus. Interested in taking over the Leather Club with all of its wealth and technology? If you can increase your total wealth to 3,500 or 350,000, they will take the settlement. If you accept their offer, the Outlanders will take possession of the Leather Club, including all items, people, and recorded research. They'll bring 5 of your people and 5 of your animals to anywhere you want on the planet to start a new colony. That's cool. I like that. So you have to do that 3 times in order to get the map. We can do that. Yeah, I don't know what the Arco Nexus map is. Bam, 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 bam. What's my current wealth? It's pretty high. It's 150,000. It's not as high as I thought it was. The higher your wealth goes, the more dangerous the raids become. So a 350,000 wealth raid's probably like 60 pirates with like everyone's got a shield belt. Shit like that. How do you wealth dump? You just get rid of stuff that isn't increasing your wealth. Or you launch it into another zone, right? You can build these things called transport pods after you research them, and you can launch supplies to people. And I'm pretty sure you can just choose to launch them to an unoccupied tile, or you can just burn it or destroy it. Or you could caravan somewhere and then just like drop them on the ground. Shit like that. Best guns in the game? I don't know. I use assault rifles because I'm a K Kona. Or send it. Yeah, you can send it as a gift. This is a social fight. meaning they'll punch each other for a little bit and then be done with it. I've never seen these guys social fight before, but apparently they hate each other a lot. Every pawn has... Damn, owned. This bitch has... Oh, her shooting used to be 19. I guess it went down. Alright, so we're checking to see if... they lost any limbs? Doesn't look like they did. Because you can break or destroy limbs, which is pretty bad. Where's Puss at? We're going to treat these guys without medicine because it's only blunt wounds that they have. This will help us save on medicine. And these guys are on bed rest too, which means they're going to get up immediately. Also, I forgot, I never said this guy's work stuff. We're going to have him on animal handling as well. Because the animal pen's so far away that it takes so much time to actually manage. So the more people that are managing it means they'll have more time to do other stuff. I think I might actually have this guy... Nah, we could have... Man, I don't know. Actually, let's have this guy cook and then handle. We'll put Cat Piss on hunting, which will help her retrain her shooting. And then we'll have this guy grow when he's not doing either of those things. Plant cut when he's not doing any of those things. And then uncheck everything else. You can just leave this stuff at 4. Boom. We've set his schedule. That's what it's going to be for a long time. I need 4 goggles. Black goggles. Maybe 5. Any questions, Twitch chat? Checking my animals for any training that they might be able to do. How do caravans work? Step 1. Go to miscellaneous in the architect thing. Find caravan packing spot. Put it directly in the middle of your stockpile. Because what they're going to do is when you make a caravan, they're going to pick all of their pack animals and then they're going to go and bring them to the caravan packing spot and then load the animals up and then leave the map. To start a caravan, you just click the world tab. I have launched the ship, but it was a long time ago. Go to world tab. Select your base. Form caravan. Right click destination. Accept. And then you choose all the people you want to go, all the pack animals you want to go. And you can tell if they're pack animals because these will have values right here. And then what items you want and travel supplies you want. You can have it do it automatically. I like to do it manually. And then you hit send, and then they do all that shit that I said. How well is this colony doing compared to others? I think we've gotten lucky, so... That's how well. Where's the drill at? What's this game about and how has it made you an addict? This game has made me an addict because it... It is, very good. Still a hole in base? No, there's no hole. Where's the drill at? I see your walls always being one block wide. It's no benefit to having them too wide. If your walls are getting breached, then they're going to get breached no matter how wide they are. I had a group of 3 pirates with hand grenades blow... through a 6 wide wall right here. Where's the stockpile? Oh, I never deleted it. Oops. Where is the actual drill? We've got the scanner, but where's the drill at? Is it production? Deep drill. Nice. Yoshi Master 67. Is there an end goal in this game? Yes, there's multiple ways to win the game. I recommend Googling that if you're interested. Bam, 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 bam. Oh, this hole. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, 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 bam. What? You bitch. We have to include this in our home area for us to be able to repair it. I don't like having an expansive home area. If you're going to play RimWorld, highly recommend getting the, what's the mod? The clean area mod? I forget. Let's have anime sounds. How do you make your colonists fuck? Just have them socializing with each other at the same time? It's called cleaning zone. Basically, what this cleaning zone mod does is it makes it so that you go and you make an allowed area. You select new area, and then you'll be like, cleaning. And then you'll mark what area you want to be cleaned, and then once you do that, you go to this icon on the bottom right, and then you select what area you want to be cleaned. This is very important because by default, when you make a structure, it will automatically expand the home area around that structure. This is what it looks like right here. All this shit right here. And what that means is if you don't have the cleaning mod, then the people who are cleaning, or you have set to cleaning, which is a very important task, will run all the way to space where you built your border wall and clean the literal fucking dirt from the ground near the wall. So get the cleaning tool so that your characters are only cleaning important zones instead of your whole home area. Very important. Building. We have now a research project. Let's get animal prosthetics. Is there a Roomba mod? Yeah, there's tons of cheater mods you can get that'll like auto clean for you and stuff if that's what you need to make the game fun for yourself. When pawns are knocked out, they will drop their shit. So don't forget to re-equip them. Making the flat goggles. So here is the staple of good combat equipment, okay? You want a helmet so you don't get shot in the brain. You want goggles so you don't get shot through the eye, which will also hurt your brain. You want a duster of some kind, not cloth usually, because cloth dusters suck. And a flak vest. And then maybe something for your feet as well. It takes a long time to be able to make that shit. But defensive gear makes a big difference in combat. Case in point, we had a guy in plate mail, or multiple guys in plate mail, hold the line against, it was like 12 mega spiders or some shit. Do until you have X tick count equipped and set count to one more than your colonists, no more tainted clothes. You mean tattered clothes? That's a good idea. I never thought about doing that. See, I'm learning stuff. Because I'm trash. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I have 12, I think. Do until I have blah. Count equipped. Nice. Neat. That's cool. We'll worry about that in a little bit. Set quality and count equipped to 51%. I don't think you have to do that, do you? Fifty-two and up. I can do 51 and up. I've never played Sunset Overdrive. This guy's been a Bilious for a long time, and we kind of dropped the ball. We were supposed to switch to Recruit after that. This guy's just going to be another hauler. Hauling's very important in this base. Oh, he's going to handle animals, too. Because our pen's so fucking far away. At the seventh hour, I like to have rituals because my night owls and my people during the day are still awake. So we're going to do a ritual right now. We do scarification rituals, which kind of suck if it happens on certain limbs, because it will reduce their movement speed if it's on their legs and shit. Our religious leader, the Leather Man. She's a woman. Now we're gonna see where the scar went. On the head. Having it on the head's very good. I think it may cause more pain than usual. That ritual in particular takes like 3 hours. It's really long. And really annoying as a result. And everyone wants to be scarified, so. Nelly and Nelly, thanks for subbing. Is it lit over here? No. Nice. Now it's lit. TM. I think we need another cleaner. Looks like we have multiple cleaners. Pussa is a cleaner and a warden. Catpiss is a cleaner and a hunter. Do you have any animals worth hunting right now? Let's tame a couple more muffalos. Let's execute the rest of them. Let's tame the borpa and the gorpa. Execute the alpacas. Execute the does. Execute the turkeys. Maybe a boulder mint as well? I forget what these do. Genetically engineered crab. Trainability none. They drop rocks? Oh. Cool. Is there a priority deconstruct? I don't think so. What was the point of those gates? It was supposed to slow them down. The people raiding me. But that was changed in the most recent version of the game. stop now, Kakona. Stop. Stop it. Right now we're actually padding our wealth a little bit. Probably shouldn't, but... Stop it. Stop. Everyone's in a really good mood. At the seventh hour, we need to remember to, do the ritual. Also, important note, you can do barrack-style sleeping. My guys benefit not in any particular way from barrack-style, other than, I'm too lazy to make bedrooms. So, keep that in mind. Meow, meow, meow. Meow, meow, meow. The fucking anime death noise. See you soon, Billy. Gonna wall that off again. We have multiple people hunting. Ooh. Well, it's a good thing we got the boys here, because this is going to turn ugly real quick. Damn. You know what? Why don't we just murder these guys as a squad? How? He like pulled out the dagger, dude. Holy fuck. Muffalos retaliate, which is pretty obnoxious. So it's good we have multiple hunters, otherwise they would have gotten fucked up, dude. Now, if we had the spare supplies and time, we could actually fill these spots between the fences with traps, and it would be, like, really good. I gotta do something about these bio-coded weapons. Let's make a new stockpile. Critical. Clear all. Weapons. Allow non-biocoded? No. I think I have another one of these. I can't remember though. Damn, look how slow that is. That's how it used to be moving across anything. You see how he slides over that one? That's just because there's no space. So we're gonna get that out of there, actually, because it speeds it up. Honestly, maybe we still put spaces here. That could be good because people will stop in order to shoot at us. They get a little cover, but that's okay. Also, I think, who's our new cook? Hung. We mark all of our food in the fields, all the supplies out here to be hauled urgently. Because the longer it stays out in the open, the faster it decays. It's very cringe. That guy took snorting yayo. Oh, he's got a chemical interest. Where's the yayo at? So characters with chemical interest will found it. Fuck you, bitch. Get the fuck out of my house, Borpa. I hate you. Also, I think we didn't set our cleaning areas properly. Yep, this is our cleaning area right here. I was wondering why this wasn't getting cleaned. Especially this room. Bam, 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 bam. Borpa, get in the pen, dude. Yo. We're gonna need a bigger fridge, I think. I love this song. Muffalo are worth a lot of meat. And I think the blue fur is kind of good, but also I'm not sure. 81% on sharp. Light leather's 54. Plain leather's 81. So it's no different than plain leather, I think, in terms of defense against bullets. Bullet. Or must have good stats for first three colonists. I'll tell you what I like. Ooh. I like someone who's really good at construction. I like someone who is really good at growing. And then I think a doctor. Those are the three essential ones. Because you can defend against raids with like traps and shit for a long time. Doctor's important, especially if you're playing higher difficulties, because you could just get diseased and fucked if you don't have the ability to treat it well. Fucked. Fucked and sucked. I might make doors through here. I don't know. What's the best pet to have? Are ground runners vanilla? I don't think so. Those ones are cool. What's the best vanilla pet to have? I don't know. Wargs. Must have mods for new players. Allow tool, cleaning area, whatever the cleaning one's called. What else? Am I building an arc down there? Vanilla expanded stuff is fun. You can see what you want to enable and don't want to enable. Increase stack size if you're lazy. No, increase stack size if you're a cheater. It's okay to be a cheater if you're bad at video games. Camera Plus is good. P Music, good. Increase stack size. This guy's stacking 5,000 steel. Animals. Mark the Borpa for training. Damn, it's fucking Omega beautiful in this bitch. That's the workshop, baby. Sugma, going for a walk. Alright, let's look for some unhappy people. We can use, Tortured Artist. We don't want to reduce that, guys. All right, sheesh, my husband Combo died, minus 20. That's pretty bad. This guy's getting fucked even more, though. So we're gonna use Pussa to reassure Tugs. Oh, no, Council, Tugs. This will negate the highest negative thought he has, if it succeeds. Canceling mood impact of minus 18. So he gets a plus 18 for 8 days, I think. Very poggers. Rescue Fatty? I want to rescue Fatty. We just haven't gotten the mission yet. Begone thought. Naku, thanks for subbing. Leak C, thanks for subbing. Any other questions? Question mark. Check social to see if Fatty's still alive. It would say they would get a mood debuff if he died. That's how you tell. How do you res combo? So we're looking for a specific item. It's called like, I forget what it's called actually. Resurrector Mech Serum, that's what it's called. Bam, 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 bam. Royalty versus ideology? I like them both. I like the fact that I could do both. Damn, this bitch has pumped out a ton of art. God damn. Bam, 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 bam. We're gonna deconstruct this torch because we don't need it in here. Looking for people with construction. I know that I have construction enabled to move this shit. We got a hospital bed in here so we can remove their organs and shit at a high success rate. Bulk goods trader, it's a spaceship passing by. We know that because we have a comms console. So we're gonna use our best negotiator slash social person to talk to them. Now, what do we want? We could sell the horses. People in the caravan will ride the fastest available animals. Oh. Never mind, we're not selling those. A radiac is a peaceful herbivore bred to thrive in high radiation environments. This, composed of 6 bionic stomachs reinforced with lead-lined bio-lattice designed to extract residual radioactive material from grass cells. This radioactive material is then deposited into crystal-like formations that pierce the hard skin of the creature. Crystals can be harvested periodically and refined to uranium in a standard chem fuel refiner. How expensive are these? Oh, 3,255. I can't afford that. We're gonna get rid of some leather here. Maybe. Some of the less ones that we have. Except the Arctic Lion, because the Arctic Lion is poggers. We're going to get rid of the wool. We're going to get rid of the drug. We're going to get rid of Question mark? Bananas. Bananas. We're gonna get rid of this 51% duster. We're gonna get rid of the 57 one. Some shit that they've got for me, not interested. Where is my third plate mail? Bwam, 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 bwam. Orpa skin kneel sheet. Large bin. A large bin to help keeping the area around it clean. Yeah, that's one of the cheater mods that I have. I don't use it though. But I could. No train ability. I don't know. What do we want? Chem fuel. Wait, maybe steel, actually. Do they have steel? 200. 400. I need more steel, boys. Nutriamine to make meds? I actually have 100 of that, so. If you could have any RimWorld pet trained in real life, what would it be? The one that comes. Exotic animal prosthetics. Tight. Let's tame some more horses if we can actually ride them. Bumble drone. Trainability intermediate. Poison shock troop. Should we try to tame these? 10% aggro rate is pretty bad. Father, I need bionics. The Borpas actually will attack and defend, so. Dark beast. Mechanoid-infused variant of Thunder Beast in which the bioelectric organs have been removed and replaced with metallic spikes and housing a distributed cloud of sun-blocking mechanites. These deployable mechanite clouds can cover a huge region, blanking it in darkness, and it is thought that the Dark Beast was created as a terrorist weapon that attacks settlements by depriving them of sunlight. Tame. Nightling. I want some, yeah, we need some of these things right here. They have advanced trainability, which will increase our handler's skill. So let's train all of the nightlings as well. And then, do yaks produce milk? I forget. Yeah. Let's get a couple of yaks. And then kill the rest. Nice. Oh, we're finally deconstructing. That's very good. The anime noise. Caravan animals wander in. Alright, so when that happens, that means an animal from a destroyed caravan somewhere else on the map wandered into our cell, aka our zone, and they have gear on them randomly. So we're gonna see what they got. 16 incendiary mortar shells. Nice. Typically, what I like to do for these is kill them. I think we should, because we're running out of space down there. We got cat piss. It's time to murder. Don't try to run. My stuff now. Yeah. That's that good anime noise. Let's go ahead and hold one of those right away. It's actually nighttime, so this guy's going all the way out here and missing his recreation time, which is why we have recreation time when they wake up as well. Because he's dumb. Come, because he's come. I think we're good to stop on blocks. No, we're not, actually. So this may look like a lot of stuff, but this is actually just two trips. I'm thinking what I want to do. Wait, no, we have to keep that there. We should just make that a wall. Construct that. Another important part about having strong walls, like not marble walls or wood walls, is that bullets that you miss get, they will hit the walls behind what you're shooting at and will damage it. And obviously if the wall in this maze is damaged, then it kind of negates a part of the maze. Which sucks a da dick. No, I need that one there too, actually. Maybe like this? Nah, that's fine. I think the stockpile zone for biocoded weapons actually accepts weapons. It does. LOL. Good catch. LOL. Alright, it's almost the 7th hour, which means we should do another scarification. We have to do 3 scarifications for each colonist, and we are behind by 5 people. This takes 3 hours each time, in-game. Into the watermelon temple. You got shingles like me? That's what you get for laughing at me! Now you've got shingles! The bonus about that taking so long is they'll get a small buff. Bam, 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 doo, boo, boo. I should stop making art soon. But we could sell it. So maybe not. Bam, 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 bam. So after everything has been constructed, the people who are set to construction will then begin repairing everything within your home area. And then after that, they will begin smoothing down walls and floors. Hello, Satan animal. I also want to put a door on this side so we could prevent a situation like how Fatty got kidnapped. Animal. We should get bionics for ourselves, actually. Maybe hydroponics, actually. That would help our food problem a lot. Hydroponics for a Devil Strand. How are you alive? No, my animals! Wait, who was making this? Yeah, I want Van to go do it. No, my aminals. Please. Please. Is there unlimited ammo? Yes. Although there are mods where you can get ammo. I don't know about that though. Meow, 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 meow. Sometimes if you build walls over the border? I don't know. I've never done it. I'm right on the border, so. What is this stockpile? What is this stockpile? It's the same. Bruh, hurry. They need to be chopped. Hung, hurry. They need to be chopped. Chop. 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 So at this point, we've got a lot of food, and I think I'm just gonna bank a million food. Actually, let's get a... Let's make 20 fine meals. And then 200 simple meals. Why do you forbid them to craft traps? Because I have a limit... I don't have much steel right now, so. I need to begin strip mining again. Turn them into packaged survival meals? More like packaged cum meals. Much of the ingredients are wasted in the preservation process. Nah. What happens if you run out of steel on the map? You use this, ground penetrating scanner. Also, you can go to other cells and get them there if you need. Scanner will look for random minerals, and a lot of the time you will find steel because it's the most common one. So why don't we go use that? Why did you stop? Progress to guaranteed fun. Why is he stopping? Wait, is this for miners or researchers? Researchers? Okay. Here we go. I just have to turn that off then. I turn the power off to the research table. Oops. Do until you have 20. Maybe we should have this lit. Yeah. It's lit! Taming Dark Beast, here we go. Tame, 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 tame. Eat this potato. Alright, bye. Oh yeah, statue. Good idea. Dick Cheney's Eyes is the title. Sculpture portrays Dick Cheney tying Maxim's hands with professional efficiency. Maxim looks resigned to his fate. Okay. Nice. That's hot. Who do we want to deliver that? Work Frenzy Hung. That's very good because he's going to cook Omega fast now. Mm-mm. We don't need a chair over there, but we'll do it for funsies. I think this light's gonna short out because it's outside, though. Zoxers, thanks for subbing. Minson, thanks for subbing. My characters don't need comfort, so they don't need a chair. Like that. Standing lamps don't short out? Oh. Global warming. It will last anywhere between a season to several years. Suddenly risen to dangerous temperatures. Okay. Okay, Kona, what the fuck? Meow, 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 meow. Meow, 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 meow. Why don't we just have all of that unroofed, actually? In Ice Age and yours, prepare for your area to be a desert now. I'm prepared, boys. We got one. Live Tucker reaction, Moon 2A. He does look like Moon 2A, doesn't he? Tucker, that's my boy. Yeah. I mean, I guess we're also going to get him on animal handling. Yeah, maybe we should cut trees down. I don't have anyone doing it. That's probably enough. He'll get most of these. I need wood, and I don't know why. At least we'll get our corn crop, hopefully. Have we seen new videos from that Sonic guy? No. We need a broadcloth. Broad wrap. What we gonna make it out of? Let's make it out of buffalo wood. Wool. Put a helmet on. He needs Dungeon Master apparel. Archan's ears. Bam, bam, bam. Bam, bam, bam. Why don't these guys have helmets on? Storage space.